So good morning students, welcome back once again. Today we are going to start our next topic, that is revolution and the seasons. How the motion of the earth, that is known as revolution, changes or somehow makes the earth experience different kinds of seasons. Let us understand with the help of this diagram. Now students, the second motion, revolution, is the motion of the earth, is the motion of the earth around the sun in an elliptical orbit, which takes about 365, 1/4 days to complete one turn, complete one round. And if you talk about 365 by 1/4 days, it is an exact time that Earth takes to move around the sun from one particular location back to that location. But instead of 1/4, we just include 365 days in a year. To avoid the confusion. So a year just becomes of 365 days. But interestingly, you have seen and you have understood earlier also that after every 4 years, we have a leap year. In which we have 366 days. That makes a leap year. Now, from where this particular day is included into the month of February is the time that we have somehow ignored for the convenience of our own. So this 1/4, or we can say the 6 hours every year, are somehow calculated and added. 1 year, 6 hours. 2 years, 6 hours become 12 hours. Another third year, 6 hours become 18 hours. And another fourth year, 6 hours becomes 24 hours. So we know that a day is of 24 hours. So now this extra day is somehow added into a year after the 4 years in the month of February. And this particular year is known as a leap year with 366 days. Now let's move on to this thing. If you can observe this diagram carefully, this shows that the earth moves in an elliptical orbit. And thing to be noticed over here is that the inclination of the earth is same in all these four places. That means that the earth is bent or somehow inclined towards the same direction. And while it is inclined towards the same direction, it is also rotating. Rotation is the motion of the earth on its own axis. And somehow revolution is the motion of the earth on its axis as well as around the sun. So the point of notice is that it is inclined towards the same direction. So a year is somehow divided into summer, autumn, winter, spring. Now the thing is that how this happens, how seasons occur. If it is inclined towards the same direction, then the season should be same. No. Seasons will not be same. Observe carefully in your book and look over here that the sun rays during this point of time, when it is 22nd December over here, the sun rays fall directly on the Tropic of Capricorn. Now, when the sun rays fall directly on the Tropic of Capricorn, which is in the southern hemisphere, excludes us from getting the direct rays of the sun as we people are in the northern hemisphere. So simply, during winters, why we experience winters because the sun rays are directly falling on the Tropic of Capricorn. Tropic of Capricorn, and that lies in the southern hemisphere, as we have discussed about the hemisphere in our previous chapters. So, because of these, during December, we experience winter. Now, somehow, when the earth keeps on rotating and revolutioning, it reaches to this location where the sun rays directly fall on the equator. Sun rays directly fall on the equator, making 21st March as the day where night and day both are equal, where night and day both are equal. So this time is known as equinox, where day and night are having both same time. Now, after that, one earth keeps on rotating and moving around the sun, it reaches to a location where the sun rays directly fall on the Tropic of Cancer, which was missing in the case of winter solstice, that was 22nd December. The direct sun rays were falling on the Tropic of Capricorn. Now, how it happened? Because of rotation as well as revolution. The main cause because of which earlier the sun rays were falling on the Tropic of Capricorn, but now over here they are falling on the Tropic of Cancer. The main reason behind this is the revolution of the earth. Now, as the direct sun rays fall on the Tropic of Cancer and we lie in northern hemisphere, so over here northern hemisphere during 21st June, all the northern hemisphere experiences summer, and over here all the southern hemisphere experiences winter. But if you talk about over here, during this point of time in December, the southern hemisphere experiences summer and the northern hemisphere experiences winter. Now, after that, Earth keeps on moving around the sun, and it again reaches to a position during September, that is 23rd of September. Over here, again the sun rays fall directly on the equator. Again, they fall directly on the equator, and making this time again as both days and night equal. And this 23rd of September is known as autumnal equinox. Autumnal equinox, and 21st March is known as spring equinox. So, because of this, a year is divided into summer, winter, and autumn and spring seasons. So, this change takes place because of the revolution of the earth. So, I hope you might have understood the topic very well. Thank you.